Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have got a glimpse about that is what is hydrolysis, and now we are going to talk about what is actually hydrolysis. So let us understand it and let us understand that what is the effect of salt on the hydrolysis. So let us talk about it. So friends, let me talk about hydrolysis. Suppose if I have a particular salt, and if I am dissolving it in a particular solvent like suppose water. So as we know that pure water consists of the equal amount of that is H plus ion as well as the OH minus ions. So that makes the water to be neutral. But what if the H2O is being reacted with that of the ions of that is the salt, because salt is the one which consists of cation as well as it consists of anion. So suppose in that case, suppose if the cation or anion, if they both don't react with that of the respective H plus ions or the OH minus ions of the water, so obviously we'll get to know that is because there is no reaction or of the H plus ion as well as the OH minus ion with that of the salt species or salt that is cation and anion. So that the sense that we could say that the concentration of H plus ion and the OH minus ion, it will remain the same, and that's the reason that the neutrality will be maintained. But what if the particular cation or particular anion of the particular that is salt, if I am dissolving it in that is liquid or like in water, so if it reacts with the H plus ion or it reacts with that is the OH minus ion of the water, obviously it would affect the concentration of the H plus ion along with that of, we could say, that is the OH minus ion. So that is the reason among the both, that is H plus and OH minus, there would be an increase in a concentration of a particular species like of H plus or like of OH minus. So that would result in the solution to be called as acidic solution, or to be called as a basic solution, because the concentration of the H plus ion, it will, suppose if it goes on increasing, then obviously the solution will be that is acidic. And if suppose if the salt molecules or if the salt particles like the cation or anion, suppose if it reacts with that of the H plus cation of the water, so obviously we could see that the OH minus concentration of the water, it will go on increasing. And if that increases compared to that of the H plus ion that has been reacted with the species of the salt, then we could see that the OH minus ion concentration is being more, and that's the reason the solution will be more basic. So that's the reason that even salt affect the acidic nature or the basic nature of a particular solution. So that's the reason that we are going to talk about, that is the concept of hydrolysis. So let us understand this first, and then we'll talk about the more thing about what is hydrolysis. So hydrolysis is defined as the reaction in which the cations and anions, or both the ions of the salt, they react with the ions of water to produce acidity or to produce alkalinity or sometimes even neutrality. Obviously, we have got to know that is we have did this in that is the states of matter. If you remind that the chapter states of matter, in which we have talked about that is hydrogen bonding along with that of the intermolecular force of attraction. So in that case, we have taken an example where we have dissolved. We have taken an example in which we have said that any cell when dissolved in water, it has been surrounded by the water molecules. So that kind of the Na plus as well as along with that of the Cl minus that has been surrounded by the water molecules. So basically, a salt when it is dissolved in a liquid like water, it can react with that so as to produce a particular product, or because of the intermolecular interaction that we could see that a particular concentration either of the H plus ion or either of the OH minus ion, it will go on increasing, and that's the reason that the solution will be more acidic or more basic, but sometimes it will be neutral also. For example, if we dissolve NaCl in water, the solution doesn't become acidic, neither it becomes basic, it becomes neutral. So mostly we have observed that suppose if we are taking, usually we are taking suppose a strong acid as well as a strong base so as to form a salt which is derived from strong acid and strong base, that is NaCl suppose if I am talking about. And if that has been dissolved in water, so the solution remains neutral because that doesn't affect the concentration of the H plus ion, neither it disturbs the concentration of the OH minus ion, and that's the reason that the solution becomes neutral. The solution is neutral of NaCl solution. But there are also certain solutions in which suppose if we are adding a particular salt, then that solution might be turned into an acid solution or might be turned into a basic solution. So that is the reason that the concept of hydrolysis is playing a very important role. And by this, we could say that a solution can be converted into more acidic solution or can be converted into more basic solution. So that is what I wanted to talk about, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know the concept of hydrolysis, and I hope you will share this video with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.